Well, good morning, children, and welcome to Tabernacle Cardiff Sunday School. Let's begin our time together with a word of prayer. So let's make sure that we're sat nice and still, got our hands together and our eyes closed. Gracious God and our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you that once again you have brought us here safely to Sunday School. Lord, we would ask and pray that you would be with us now, Lord, during this hour of worship. And help, Lord, help us to glorify your name. For we ask all these things in our Saviour's name, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, let's begin and start Sunday School as we usually do, by singing our Sunday School prayer, which is Father in this place of worship. Well, let's remind ourselves now what we looked at last week in Tabernacle Cardiff Sunday School. Now, for those of you that were with us, you'll remember we've continued in our series on Abraham. And last week we looked at a new person, didn't we? A new man. Can anybody remember the name of that man? That's right, his name was Lot. And if we remember what our memory verse said from last week, can we remember what it said? Well, let's have a look. It's going to come up on the screen now. It's this one. Escape for thy life. Look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. And that was in Genesis chapter 19. Verse 17. And so let's say that again together. Escape for thy life. Look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. Genesis chapter 19, verse 17. And I just want to highlight two words there. Well, it's the same word, but it's in there twice. And it's this word here at the start and on the fourth line. It's that word escape. And what does escape mean? Escape means to get away from danger. And that is what the gospel message is. We are all sinners. We are all full of sin. And to be a Christian and to have the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal saviour is to escape from sin and from death. And that is what the gospel message is about. So wherever you see that word, escape, just think about the gospel being like that. So let's turn and we're going to sing our first song together now, which speaks of escaping, as we've just talked about. And it's this one. It was a new one we learnt not so long ago. Come to the Saviour, make no delay. Here in his word, he hath shown us the way. Here in our midst, he's standing today, tenderly saying, come.
Yeah.
Well, it's time to turn to God's word now. So if you have your Bible with you, could you turn with me again to the book of Genesis? And we're going to turn to chapter 24 this week. And we're going to read from verses 22, it's up on the screen there, to verses 27. So Genesis chapter 24, verses 22 to 27. So let us hear the word of God. And it came to pass, as the camels had done drinking, that the man took a golden earring of half a shekel weight, and two bracelets for her hand of 10 shekels weight of gold, and said, "Whose daughter art thou? Tell me, I pray thee. Is there room in thy father's house for us to lodge in?" And she said unto him, "I am the daughter of Bethuel, the son of Milcah, which she bare unto Nahor." She said moreover unto him, "We have both straw and provender enough and room to lodge in." And the man bowed down his head and worshipped the Lord. And he said, "Blessed be the Lord God of my master Abraham, who hath not left destitute my master of his mercy and his truth. I being in the way, the Lord led me to the house of my master's brethren." And so reads the word of God. Well, let's come to our Heavenly Father now in prayer. So let us pray. Let's make sure that we're sat nice and still, have our hands together and our eyes closed. Gracious God and our loving Heavenly Father, we do thank you for today. We thank you, Lord, that it is your day. We thank you, Lord, for the word that we have just read. And we thank you, Lord, for this time of Sunday school. Lord, we would ask and pray your blessing upon us as we meet together. Lord, we pray that as we now prepare ourselves for today's lesson, Lord, that you would help us to listen. Lord, that you would help us to understand. And Lord, that you would help us, Lord, to apply what we learn to our lives. Lord, draw near to us wherever we are. Keep us safe, Lord, and from harm. But most of all, Lord, we pray that you will forgive us our sins. Oh, help us, Lord God, we pray, and draw near to us now. For we ask all these things in our Saviour's name, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, before we come to today's lesson, we're going to sing again. And it's this one. "Give me a sight, O Saviour, of thy wondrous love to me, of the love that brought thee down to earth to die on Calvary." Well, it's now time for today's lesson, so let's make sure that we're sat nice and still and that we're ready to listen.
Hello again, boys and girls, and welcome to the fourth lesson in our series we've been following in the book of Genesis, looking at God's great plans. Abraham was an ordinary man, but he had great faith in God. Remember, God spoke to him, leading him to a new land and promising to make him the father of a great nation. We have heard the amazing true story of how Abraham and Sarah, his wife, had a baby when they were very old indeed, because with God nothing is impossible. God then tested Abraham, who continued to trust the Lord God by showing he was willing to do anything, to sacrifice even his only son, to obey God. Did you see how when God provided a lamb so that Isaac would not be harmed, that this was a picture of God providing his only son Jesus as a sacrifice for our sins? All through the Old Testament, right from the first book, Genesis, we see through pictures and prophecies that God's great plan was to send Jesus at the right time to be the Saviour of the world. The plan was that the Saviour would be born into God's own family, and the first father of this family was Abraham. Last week, we again saw how Abraham trusted and followed God, putting the Lord first in all things. This way he was kept from all the trouble that his nephew Lot got into. Lot chose the ways of the world above God's and ended up paying very dearly, barely escaping with his life. This week we have an unusual story telling us of how a wife was found for Isaac, all according to God's great plan. When we see how God works out his plan for his people, it is amazing. Although at the time it can be confusing and things may seem not to make sense, when we can look back on our own lives as well as the lives of the people we read about in the Bible, it is often surprising and wonderful. What comes to life is that although God may move in mysterious ways, he is working everything out to bring about good things for those who love and obey him. He is all wise. We can totally trust him. He is all good and kind and very patient with us. Let's have a look then at how Isaac met his wife. If you have your Bible, you can follow now and later in the first book, Genesis, and chapter 24. Hands up if you've been to the beach this summer. Have you ever built a sandcastle? You can build a very simple one with just a bucket, or you can build a really fancy one with bridges and battlements and even a moat for when the sea comes running in. Imagine if you were on a school trip and you had a sandcastle competition, but instead of choosing the best design, your teacher said, "Work out how many tiny grains of sand are in your sandcastle." What would you do? It would be impossible, wouldn't it? Hands up if you have been outside after dark on a clear night. Have you looked up and seen all the stars? Have you looked hard and seen just how many there are? They are impossible to count. In chapter 22 and verse 17 of Genesis, we see that God used these pictures of grains of sand on the seashore and stars in the sky to promise Abraham a great family that would be God's people, filling the land as far as the eye could see, more than he could count. Yet at this time Abraham was over 100 years old, his wife Sarah had died, and he had just one son, Isaac. All the same, Abraham was full of faith and believed God. And so, it was time for Isaac to get married. They were a rich, powerful family. They could consider how this marriage would benefit them when making a choice. They could take their pick from the beautiful women from wealthy families living all around them. However, both Abraham and Isaac knew that the people living around them in Canaan did not love the Lord God. Children, even though it seems like a long way off that you will need to think about who you will marry, remember this lesson and the wise approach that Abraham and Isaac took to this serious matter. Abraham was sure that Isaac should not marry a lady from the land of Canaan who did not love God. He was also sure that Isaac should not leave the land of Canaan, as it was the promised land given to them by God. He was sure that God would lead them to the right woman. So he sent his old faithful servant, Eliezer, back to his homeland where the rest of his family was still living. Eliezer was also a man of God, who prayed for God to direct him just like his masters Abraham and Isaac did. He trusted God after seeing Abraham's faith for many years. As we heard this story unfold, it can help us to trust God and trust Jesus to be our Saviour, who has paid the price for all our sins. Listen to what happens and how God led his servant. Eliezer prayed and journeyed many, many miles to have his prayers answered. When he got to the land of Haran on his camel, he met Rebekah. He had stopped at a well outside the city to get water for his camels. He asked the Lord God to direct him to a wife for Isaac amongst the women who came to fetch water from the well. He would ask the right woman to give him some water from her jug, and when she would give the water to him, she would also give it to his camels out of kindness. This is what Eliezer had agreed in prayer with God, and Rebekah was the answer to this prayer. She gave water to Eliezer and then to his camels, and he could see that she was a gracious, kind woman. She was also beautiful to look at, but it was much more important that she was lovely on the inside. As they talked, they realized that Rebekah belonged to Abraham's family, showing that she was the wife chosen by God for Isaac. Eliezer worshipped and thanked God for guiding him to the right person and hearing his prayers. He was welcomed into the home of Rebekah's family, and her father and brother agreed that the Lord had been guiding Eliezer and that Rebekah should go to Isaac and become his wife. As they travelled to Canaan, Isaac was walking in a field, praying to God, when he saw Rebekah and Eliezer coming. Soon they were married, and Isaac deeply loved his wife Rebekah. It was 23 years before they had children, but then God gave them twin boys, who we will hear about next lesson. What does God want us to learn from this lesson? What is he telling us? Isaac loved and trusted God, and God loved and took care of Isaac. God's great love is shown to all who trust him, and his great care is for all who believe in his Son, Jesus Christ, who came to this world to save anyone who would trust in him. Jesus' love is very wonderful. Do you know that chorus? So high you can't get over it, so low you can't get under it, so wide you can't get around it. Oh, wonderful love. In Paul's New Testament book called Ephesians, he describes this wonderful love in chapter 3, verse 17. He prays that Christ living in our hearts when we trust him can help us to understand that this love is vast, beyond our understanding or imagination. As your Sunday school teacher, I must warn you, you are a sinner and you need to be saved. But the other side of the coin is that there is a wonderful Saviour, Jesus, who has such a great love for you and for all who will come to him. He has been a faithful friend to all who have loved through life's journey with him. He will never let us down. What a friend we have in Jesus. Do not doubt that he loves even you. Just as he brought Rebecca to Isaac, he has brought you here today to tell you, come to Jesus and be saved. Don't delay. Will you come? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have brought us to this place to hear about Jesus. Just as you brought Eliezer to meet Rebecca, to bring her to Isaac, another in your family, the family of God, we pray that we would become a part of the family of God through trusting in Jesus, your only Son, who you gave to be the sacrifice for our sins. We thank you that he died for us. Help us to trust in his life and death and resurrection. Help us to believe and follow him. Help us, O Lord, and be with us now and in the week ahead. We pray in his name, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thanks for listening. I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.
And that was today's lesson at Tabernacle Cardiff Sunday School. It's time to have a look at this week's memory verse now, which will come up on the screen. So let's have a look at that one. And it's this one. The Lord led me to the house of my master's brethren. And that's in Genesis chapter 24, verse 27. I'll say it again. The Lord led me to the house of my master's brethren. Genesis chapter 24, verse 27. Well, it's time to have a look now at this week's take-home sheets, which are now available to download in one of the two usual ways, either by clicking on the link within the description box or by going to the church website, tabernaclecardiff.org, and there's a link there then on the home screen to the take-home sheets. So this week it's lesson 29, so make sure that you have lesson 29 on the top of your take-home sheets. And we'll have a quick look now at the infants. So that's lesson 29, God's plan for finding Isaac's wife. And also on the juniors and the teenagers, again, we've got our memory verse. It was also on the infants. We've got our memory verse there. The Lord led me to the house of my master's brethren. So that's the juniors and the teenagers. So as I mentioned, those are now available to download in those two ways. Well, it's now time to have a look at your take-home sheets from last week. Thank you. Well, it's lovely once again to see your take-home sheets, and it's good to see you all putting forward your best work and really completing those take-home sheets to the best of your ability to. So well done, everyone, for doing that in your take-home sheets. Well, we're going to sing our closing hymn together now, our closing song together, and it's this one. I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. The words will come up on the screen and we'll stand to sing. Well, it's been lovely to have you with us here today at Tabernacle Cardiff Sunday School. And I trust it's been a blessing to you too, to have been with us at Sunday School. Here's just a quick reminder as to what else is coming up on the Tabernacle Cardiff YouTube channel on this, the Lord's Day. That's us at 9:30 in Sunday School. And then shortly at 10:30, we'll follow the morning service at both the chapel and online. At 3:30 this afternoon will be Capel Rath, and that's the Welsh service. And then at 6 o'clock will be the evening service. All these services are available on the YouTube channel, and you are more than welcome to subscribe and to share this channel with your friends and family. Well, it's now time to bring Sunday School to a close. So let's come together to our Lord in prayer. So let's make sure that we're sat nice and still. Let's put our hands together and our eyes closed. Our gracious God and our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you, Lord, that it is your day. And we thank you now for this time that we have had together, Lord, in Sunday School. We thank you for your word and for what it teaches us. And Lord, we would ask and pray that you would help us to understand what we have learnt. Lord, show us our sin, show us our need of a saviour, and help us, Lord, as we seek thee, and forgive us our sins. Be with us now during this coming week, wherever we are. Lord, you know our individual needs. And Lord, we pray that you will bring us back safely to Sunday School next Lord's Day, God willing. Draw near to us now, we pray, for we ask all these things in our Saviour's name, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.